Supplementary log, entry 90. Iridonia. Its orbit is packed with debris and other pieces of ships from all the fighting. Hopefully, today is the day it ends. The first mainline strike group with Homan at its tip has finally pushed the Black Sun from it for good. Navigating all the mess in orbit apparently wasn't easy, so I've got to pass a bunch of requisitions for paint from various captains. We can't have them jump into battle with a scrap paint job now, can we? Anyhow, with that move, Akbar took the Pole's blockade fleet into a pocket, so that he could engage it without worry of reinforcements or any orbital defenses. From what I hear, the following fight went remarkably well. On my side of the galaxy, we're finally making the last moves on the Geonosis sector. The 31st mainline and the attached battlecruiser element engaged the shipyards over Geonosis. This force was more than enough to annihilate the station defense flotilla along with the shipyards. Hopefully, we can maintain this momentum and keep the ground invasion's timetable. Rear Admiral Kasper, end log. Hello everyone and welcome back to Awakening of the Rebellion, Scum and Villainy 2.10.3. Without any further intros, let's get into it. Because, like a complete dumbass, I forgot to record my microphone. This, at least the first part, is gonna be a post-commentary. As such, it's gonna be more heavily edited, I guess, to sort of condense the experience. Because you're not getting my reactions, just a commentary. Anyhow, I have made a submod so that you can download the fixes I applied to my game. There is 4 of them, I think.
Coordinates received.
And thanks to that, you can play the game as I do, with fixed mortars and fixed snipers, at least the rebel ones. Anyhow, let's just keep going. Alright, here we are considering a raid on Thrakia, since the space defense was quite robust with a Royal Dragon. We're just gonna start it with the snipers here, which are fixed in the submod, of course. Of course, the Trandoshans are very nice to have here, as they have a lot of fast speeders with light weapons. And thanks to that, the Nogri, which are usually the best anti-vehicle option in the recruiter, or the Merc camp or whatever, are pretty bad because they're very fragile. Also, most of Imperial craft are shielded, so that's also a bad matchup for disruptors. Slap a couple of AA turrets against those Hapen anti-infantry speeders, I guess. They're not roughly equivalent to snow speeders, they're much worse than snow speeders, but somewhere like that, somewhere along those lines.
Yes, sir.
We're gonna see if we can two-prong them here and sort of divide their attention. While Group 2 maintains defensive positions, near the turret, the snipers are gonna harass the enemy with quasi-artillery fire. Yeah, having Paige on the front line is a pretty shit idea. So we're gonna just pull him out, hopefully the Codas commandos can hold it good enough.
Reporting.
I'm on a micro.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Let's move out.
What's wrong?
Yes, Commander. Ready.
All right, man. Take cover.
We're gonna go here and perform something that I like to call the Kyle bait, in which we expose Kyle to horrible mortal danger just to draw the enemy into our turret. And very good idea, obviously, for me, but not for Kyle, unfortunately. Wow. War.
I'm ready. Yes?
Spot. Currently it's working pretty nice.
Let's go. Give me a target.
Right, I've rotated the snipers up to the turret. Hopefully this will give us better pull potential, as they can fire at targets from much range, and we don't have to wait for Kyle to heal up on that one poor medic that's treating him right now. Alright, I got bored. We're gonna push out the Kodas militia and Kyle to that mine over there and hopefully take it out.
On the move.
So that the
let's go.
Well, it's one building less for
cover our back. Transmission received.
For one. But also the Hapen forces won't try to go to there and protect it. So here we've got the proton charges going off, and we're almost done. Just another salvo. Come on. They're engaging. Just a couple more shots. Come on, like three proton charges. And almost there, one more. I like two more. Much better. Alright, pull out.
Right away. Over there.
Sprint out. Let me finish.
Copy.
So that we destroyed it so that I destroyed it so that the Hapen forces will come from always from the direction of the base and never from the direction of the mine, so they're a little bit more predictable in that manner.
Yes, right away.
We've got a big
orders confirmed.
We've drawn them out, but they're still outside of the range of our triple laser, but they're gonna pull back when we try to pull, unfortunately. And well, that's the end of the engagement. We retreat to our emplacement. They retreat to their base.
Ready, sir.
That's it.
Where do you need me?
Alright, so now I'm trying to pull these forces. You can see in the
reporting.
Right here, Group 2 is already prepositioned to pounce on the occasion if they get drawn out. Let's see if they take the bait. They're firing, but I don't think the AI gets what I'm trying to do and will just right-click on the snipers here. And if I can draw them out far enough, I should be able to sneak behind them, but I decided not to risk it against the Arcan tank. I hoped to draw the whole force, not just part of it. And that's decided to retreat.
Okay,
a couple of vehicle shots here. Paige is gonna boost our fire rate. I guess of no one except himself, because no infantry was near enough to him. That ability should really use a bit larger range, honestly.
Ready.
Anyhow, we're gonna keep probing with our snipers. Trying to pull their forces into our turbo laser. But I'm gonna skip the cat and mouse game here. Anyway. Right, one of our snipers just went down here, so we're gonna call in the gunners with the mortar here, so that the mortar can harass the enemies better, hopefully with its 1000 range. and shield piercing. Shields on the Hapens are preventing us from dealing major lasting damage to the Hapen vehicles. Yeah, we're gonna position it somewhere just north of the tower, turbo laser tower, so that it can support snipers can spot for it, but no one is too far up front.
Ready for battle. Roger that. On our way, sir.
Right, we've got a good pull here.
This one's mine.
I'm attempting to target down the tanks, but I don't think they're gonna stick long enough for us to deal enough damage. Something went down, another sniper team perhaps? Or maybe one of the...
Reporting.
Maybe one of the forward... No, the militia teams are up there. The militia teams are gonna be attempting a flank here, too.
Transmission received.
Being prepositioned, and we're gonna try to pull again.
Yes, Commander. Right away.
With our snipers,
yes.
And with the Trandoshan snipers, we just recruited too. And the other mortar unfortunately went down,
ready,
so
sir.
We don't have double the mortar firepower, which is gonna bring up the gunners to the back of the Trandoshans to give them some fire support.
Heading out. Fall out, troops. Yes, sir. Got something for me? Yes, Commander.
The enemy is being shelled. The mortar is very inaccurate. But it's dealing damage nonetheless. Especially to those lightly armored speeders.
Roger that. Ready?
Come on. Alright, maybe another pull.
Form up. Let's move out.
Nope. I'm gonna skip the cat and mouse here again. Alright, we managed to get a good pull here. Jumping right into the action, skipping the pull itself, and the militia teams are gonna go in behind with rushdown. Hopefully increase their proton charge reload times, but I don't think we can get a full reload inside the time the rushdown lasts anyhow. So we're just gonna have to pray that they'll deal enough damage. Not pray, I mean we're just gonna have to hope that the regular timer is enough. But it seems like the Hapens are committed here to that, and looking for a good target here. Someone, no one without shields. Just get the gunners and the snipers firing on that with low shields. The mortar is drawing fire, which is not very good, but it's probably necessary. Turret taking heavy damage from light fire because building armor is pretty terrible. Actually, the one thing the one type of damage the buildings are good against is heavy damage, heavy ground damage. But with the turret broken and Paige in danger, we're gonna attempt to pull everyone out with Paige first.
Transmission received.
Because losing a minor hero this late into the playthrough would be pretty terrible. Especially since I don't think we lost a hero.
Loud and clear. Roger that.
I'm gonna pull everyone out
right away.
Here to get on the action and possibly attempt a pincer later. That could be an option.
headquarters.
Yeah. Thought about sprinting them out, but Paige doesn't have sprint. Paige has take cover, so these guys are just gonna have to hold here for a bit, take the damage. I was a bit worried because I wasn't sure that we can rebuild the commandos as New Republic, but we can rebuild commandos as New Republic, fortunately.
Copy. Fallout troops.
Right, Group 5 has arrived on scene with their fresh proton charges. And the bikes are still providing some meat shielding, I guess, because it's hard to call it anything else because they're just dying.
Let's go.
That AE gun is gonna die too. The base is destroyed. We're gonna pull back to closer to our bunker there.
Reporting.
The map is revealed, it's revealed to us that there is just four famous speeders left, or however you pronounce it. Nonetheless, these turrets here are going down, despite the enemy's low numbers. I don't really have anything to contest this with, actually, except one open slot in the pop, which I missed. Probably another sniper died. So we're just gonna get here the rocket team, the infiltrator rocket team, and the commando rocket team, I guess, and clean them up before they destroyed the last AA gun.
Right behind you.
Come on, and it's dead. Alright, all in all, pretty good trades. Now I'm frantically checking. Yep. Frantically checking whether we can rebuild them. Yes, we can. Big sigh of relief there. But we now need to get our eco up, not forgetting that this thing needs garrison. And so that we can pull the commandos off. And of course the Haypans have, still have a ground force in parts of the ground force in orbit, a Fima speeder and one of those shitty open top flyers.
Construction complete.
Couple the rocket teams, I guess. The final rocket team didn't get pulled down.
Construction complete.
Assault frigate here.
Whatever. Those which can hold ground best.
Constructing unit.
Orders received.
Now we're gonna be up for the shakedown, I guess, of the Alliance Assault Frigate Mark II. I really wanna try it out. But I think it lost its powered weapons. Just leaving it with the shield boost. Of course, with all that tech and I was talking something about the ships.
Unit in production.
Yeah, we probably need the big tanky independences first, instead of the Republic class star destroyers, which are rather fragile for their size. All right, the shakedown is gonna commence over Thrakia. It's a good test ground for the Alliance Assault Frigates. First run to go and feel how they move, how they turn, because we just need to perform a small mop-up operation here. And so I chose this target, moved the fleet off screen, no biggie, got some administrative work done. That's about it. Anyway, that's the defensive shield I was talking about. Not really a shield Or a shield boost, not shield overcharge. I think shield boost is the shield regeneration boost ability's name. Anyway, the shield ability I was talking about earlier. We're just gonna go in ham. And I'm contemplating here whether I want some air support here, but really, as Rebellion, you need the air support because most of your ships have pretty terrible AA in single heavy laser cannons, which can't hit anything.
A-Wing Squadron reporting. A-Wing reporting.
Nebulon B.
We're getting
weapons armed.
Right, I'm popping the defensive shield here. Hopefully this will minimize the damage enough so that that frigate survives. I'm going to move everyone up to protect this frigate, and the very slowly. Everyone else is gonna focus on the Purgle Ultras. I completely wasn't expecting the Purgles here. It didn't look at the mission's objective screen down in the bottom right, but because of that, my frigate is gonna pay the price. The Hapens are two-pronged in the frigate, which is very bad, but the Purgle Ultras are almost done, along with their squads, thanks to our E-Wings and their abilities. Unfortunately, the Nebula is affecting ability usage here. When they're fly in and fly out, it's quite irritating. Oh god, there's another Purgle Ultra. There were actually three Purgle Ultras. Nope, this one's still here. Yeah, there were three Purgle Ultras. I'm gonna attempt to get the frigate out while everyone else focuses their missiles
ready to engage
on the Purgle Ultra that actually has a armor-piercing or shield-piercing attack. Of course, the bombers are no joke too, so retarget some of the, or retask some of the E-Wings to the Hapen space fighters. The Nova Cruisers were cleaned up, just some Beta Cruisers left. We can watch now the K-Wings do their work, or at least a flyby, because I don't think we're gonna launch any missiles. We can just watch the carnage at least. Well, turrets were plenty in action. And it looks like our little frigate survived this encounter. It's not yet done, or the battle is not yet done, and I'm worried that the Hapens have something weird in store for us, so I just got the fighters on scouting duty while the rest of the fleet assumes defensive formation in between the nebulas. Maybe a bad move by me because the nebulas affect vision, but they affect their vision too. Never mind, nothing important or nothing scary, just some transports. Hopefully the K-Wings, actually we'll see if the K-Wings can murder them as they should, but unfortunately the missiles are not, neither the missiles nor the torpedoes are very accurate against them, and the transports have point defense cannons, very accurate, very irritating, and the K-Wings are a very large target, so the PD, especially at close range, can hit very reliably. Not very agile too, so won't be dodging anything. Just hoping that the enemy gunners are bad. Also, the fighters are not helping either. You could see two K-Wings have gone down right now. Looks like, no, just, yeah, two. One squadron is far. K-Wings. We're gonna split it up to pairs, two two squadrons are gonna go after the fighters. The final one is gonna bully the transport. But the E-wings are incoming, and they're gonna be able to blast the fighters with their target lock ability, which basically triples their firepower and doubles their range. And that's it.
Construction complete.
Destination acknowledged.
Alright, after this impressive performance by the Alliance Assault Frigate, we're gonna slap them over. We're gonna attempt to slap the Imperials over Mercury with them. Just going. Well, not actually blind because we saw something
vectors
there,
set.
But.
Tactical
or the two Golan platforms there. Anyway.
There they are!
Right, we passed deployment. We can see on the radar, thanks to the large or the good sensors of our E-wings, that the enemy has a bunch of Arcadens cruisers here, in addition to the stations and the Golan platforms. So we're gonna attempt to shell them with K-wings. We've brought every K-wing we could get from the carriers, and then every K-wing that would fit as a Justice Squadron. And here we go. Nebula's blocking their sensors, so we're gonna get a bunch of lag. The cool part is that the tracking missiles are gonna sort of curve off in very pretty angles. Actually, it might be an interesting way to make missiles curve. Just put a jammer thing there. Huh. Maybe someone could look into that. And we've got somewhat of a pool, but I don't think. Nah, they're just gonna attempt to shell us. But the poor fighters that were sent to chase us off are not gonna fare well against the full might of our flak-equipped quasars. And now we turn around and blast them with the superior guns of the E-wings. K-wings lending a hand too. Not needed, but appreciated. And they're just returning, looks like, back to their defensive stance. Anyway, now we're gonna get the K-wings to the side, and hopefully,
standing by.
Hopefully, remedy the problem of the jammer nebula.
Power shield.
By, well, just moving aside, firing from a different angle. This brave dreadnought, I don't know if it's brave or stupid, but it's gonna face off against our missiles. And now the K-wings have cleared the nebula and can turn in and put their firepower against the victory. Right. And rifle. Jeez, that's a lot of missiles. Yep, that's why K-wings are K-wings. Now we're gonna pull them off. We don't want them to get into close range with all these laser cannons on the Arcadens and the heavy laser cannons on the Victor Burgess, which are gonna blast them to smithereens. Anyway, the Karax are gonna be the biggest problem here, as only the assault missiles on the K-wings are the dedicated weapon. The only ship with a dedicated weapon against Karax that we have, so we're gonna blast them at close range. Hopefully the artillery rockets are gonna hit them too. Massive overkill despite my quick retargeting. As you can see by the flare of missiles just flying into space. The enemy bombers are flanking us and it's not good. We're gonna get the quasars to intercept as they're closing in on the most damaged frigate. Unfortunately, that frigate is probably not gonna make it because it doesn't have any shields anyway. So, bombers or no bombers, that's not gonna make much big of a difference.
Frigate responding.
Right. Here is a repositioning. The K-Wings are going after the next target they have, which is the Architans. I'm still trying to save that frigate, but yeah, it's gonna go down right now. Yep, unfortunately, one of the four first frigates is down. The AAE and the interceptors need to go on and intercept the fighters chasing our K-Wings and harassing, and the bombers harassing us. And chase off the bombers harassing us, but fortunately the Victory's shield is now down and the Alliance Assault Frigates can move it for the kill with their main batteries, not just the missiles. Narcadence is attempting, I guess, to flank us, but that's too little too late, unfortunately. If that came to bite us in the ass when the bombers were also flanking us and the fleet engagement was going on, that might have been bigger of an issue, but now we can just leisurely send in the fighters to spot the Golan and have the K-Wings engage. That I haven't learned my lesson and the K-Wings are going to attempt to, nope, they're not going to attempt to fire through the Neglet because I divert them back out. The E-Wings are engaging the enemy fighters. That ability, the target lock ability, is working wonders here against enemy gunships, and now even the powerful point defense of the Golan, which is actually basically a big nope to any kind of MC-80 or MC-30 rush, is gonna fold to the sheer amount of missiles the K-Wings can produce from themselves. Got, hopefully, yep. One pass is enough with the torpedoes getting involved, and now the K-Wings are reloaded again and can blast down the main station here, flying through the remains of the Golan, and it's dead. And now the enemy has basically no chance of doing anything to us at all. As such, they retreat.
Roger that. Let's go.
Right, and now we're going down to Geonosis.
Invasion commencing.
As our artillery has arrived and we can finally assault this heavily fortified area. Geonosians, of course, are gonna be on our side here, and I'm directing them straight to the factory that I know it's there, while the speeders are gonna search for another factory that I know is somewhere around here, but I don't really know where it is exactly. So we're gonna find out.
I still don't remember
where it is exactly, even though I literally played this before. The Droidekas are not gonna be very helpful here. I kind of wanted some AATs, but well, I guess it's better than nothing. The Geonosians are gonna catch enemy artillery out of position there.
Ready.
While I micro all the other units on pause. Now they're engaging.
Secured a build pad.
Yes, sir.
Yep, the snipers are gonna ping to reveal, finally reveal that factory.
Roger that, right away.
And now we just build up some turrets and yeah, whatever, curse. That pad, build pad was not under our control yet. I'm just gonna retask all Geonosians to engage the enemy artillery so that they can't consolidate their forces and make a proper battle line. And they need to engage us here and now with that artillery. We're also capping the nearby landing zone so that we can bring in some heavy armor to help us with that, with those 80 APs.
We've secured a build pad. Turret constructing.
Come on, Geonosians.
Form up. Moving ahead. Awaiting orders. Heading out, sir. Copy. Fall out, troops. Let's move out.
Right, they're engaging one of the squads. Is gonna push to the side to cap that, hopefully get a turbolaser tower, and we'll bring in the heavy armor as the as our landing zone is captured. No, our landing zone's under our control. Snipers are gonna attempt to keep their distance. I'm gonna attempt to have them to keep their distance.
We've secured a build pad.
We have the Gargantuan and General Iblis with us.
Turret is
turret
going up.
Constructing.
Gargantuan is down. He's gonna attempt to engage the speeders.
Target confirmed.
With the supporting tanks, of course.
Weapons armed.
That bunker is definitely going down. Don't have a way to cap it before we destroy it with heavy laser guns and things.
I read you.
Reporting. Ready to deliver.
Yep. I'm gonna now engage the AP.
How can I help?
Seems like it's either the last one or the second to last one. And the Geonosians are gonna push up, secure the large build pad, which for some reason the Black Sun didn't want to build on.
How can I serve the Alliance?
Of course, the Geonosians are very fragile and very low, not range, but sensor range. The engagement range is pretty decent actually. But now we've got some criminal AATs here, which are gonna launch some missiles against us, but that should... But... Fuck. And because of that, I'm gonna build the repair station to fix up current Belibles. The second droid factory was just... B2s, so no 80s still, unfortunately. And the consortium is attempting to do a push into our side a bit, but we're gonna get them from the flank, at least a slight flank with our heavy armor. We could see that the heavy speeder pushed back to avoid destruction just in time. Now the Nordekas are gonna hold the foreground here. Their repeating blasters are pretty okay against infantry. Not very good, unfortunately, not very accurate. And we're gonna get a bunch of turrets to shield them from blaster fire, despite their heavy shields, very heavy shields. For an infantry unit, they're still very fragile to literally anything.
Roger that.
As any other small droid.
Choose for reinforcements.
You can't have my part.
Alright, skipping some light skirmishing here to back to the proper action, and they're gonna attempt, the enemy is gonna attempt a counterattack against us with some AATs, but our tanks are already prepositioned to thwart their attempt, and we're gonna we're gonna be able to enjoy some cinematic cam. Unfortunately, the enemy is actually has a lot more infantry than I anticipated, so the tanks are gonna have to retreat. But both the artillery is in range, and the bombing run is ready to lend us a hand. We're falling back to the secondary line where the Droidekas are gonna have a field day on that infantry, and the Buings are engaging right on the money with the bombs against the ATAP, destroying their key, their last key support unit here. Now it's just the question of cleaning up the rest of the infantry and the couple of spears they have left here.
What's the plan? I can do that.
The infantry, of course, was damaged too by both by the Droidekas and the Buings guns. Right, just letting you know that this building is going down as it's very positioned very much forward. The Black Sun doesn't really have a response against our artillery and combined with our tanks here, especially since the building is gonna go down in seconds. Alright, the snipers here are moving forward now, and we're gonna ping, reveal the enemy infantry, and the bombardment is gonna finish the job here. Hopefully, they shouldn't be unable to run away. The snipers, of course, were out of on scouting duty because the bombardment was ready. They were just looking to pass down the target. And now with hopefully most of the infantry dealt with, it's just gonna be a cleanup operation with the turrets and some buildings. We'll see you just before the victories. Right, the Geonosians are now engaging what's left of their infantry, and the snipers are pulling up. I'm gonna scan up by their base as the bombing run is ready, and carefully place the reticle over their base. The Buings are incoming. Now hopefully they don't have any Mazravel turrets like this one. Geonosians need to take it out, or at least distract it, to give our Buings a clean shot at the base, and hopefully they're just gonna clean it up with one run and the enemy is gonna surrender. Let's see. And Pickle. Good hits on target. It's almost destroyed. Geonosians might be able to clean this up. Let's see how much health it has left.
What are your orders?
Come on, just a couple of shots more.
Gargantuan ready.
Kinda sucks that you can't see. You can't really see their projectiles. They should be like pretty nice, bright, and green. Pretty cool looking, actually. Unfortunately, this mod doesn't have that, and we're victorious once we destroy their main building. Of course. Unfortunately, the game threw us another curveball here, as a black market just finished production as we took control of the planet. So now our units are sort of hidden, but they're on the planet surface. So we're just gonna drag Kota down, I think. Come on, yep. To begin the engagement and get rid of that black market and regain our units. And we don't have the three H tanks that we had.
What is it?
The two platoons of the three H's, which really sucks. I'm looking for them, but also all the turrets also lost. We screwed this build, but yes. Anyway, after we get rid of the Draven Speeder, everything is dead already. Even before I finish the sentence.
System conquered. Construction complete.
Right after this pretty irritating ordeal, I'm just gonna do some more administrative work around the galaxy here. Yeah. We'll see you when something interesting happens.
Tactical battle.
The invasion of Ratak, or the Imperials are attacking Ratak, and look around. Yep, we can now build the Mandator Star Dreadnought, which should be able to just chase off
building started
the Imperials from Ratak by itself once it's finished. Tech, but of course it has to finish. It's like 20 minutes build time, even with two shipyards. Despite the fact that this force is not that big, we will be
building
or
under
I
construction.
Won't really be able to engage it with anything.
Building
anyhow,
under construction.
Let's just queue up a couple of defensive stations over Bakura
as construction.
I don't really want to lose our Bakuran destroyer supply to the Empire.
Complete.
But
construction complete.
After, of course, the Grand Invasion, which is gonna be just after that, I'm gonna realize, or I'm gonna end the segment, and when I begin
complete.
A segment the next, or when I begin recording the next day, I'm gonna realize,
en route.
Or when I look at the recording the next day, I'm gonna realize that I didn't plug in the microphone correctly.
Constructing unit, construction complete.
So anyway, we'll see you, or you'll
tactical
hear
battle,
a, you'll hear
destroyed.
A live commentary me right after this cut. And we're back with voice this time. I completely forgot that I should enable a channel for the microphone. So I ended up not recording the voice. So you probably heard a voiceover as in a post commentary voiceover for that last segment. Right, but we did some things. We built a couple of these. Nothing much happened. Ratak got attacked. Blah, blah, blah. We, of course, queued up this guy. That's about it. Yeah, we tested. We did test out the assault frigates, but they're nothing special, honestly. We can leave a blockading force.
Underway.
Here.
Construction complete.
That
coordinates
just
received.
That.
Space tech level advanced. New options available.
Cool. I think that's Frigs 2.
Tactical battle imminent.
Oh. That makes sense. Actually, this might be defendable depending on what we get. Two tectors, one VSD, I think that was. There is sender over there. No, there is sender over there.
Enemy
this is the
ahead.
Gas giant it orbits.
Your orders?
Z95s? Oh shit.
Ready for command.
X-Wings! Get on it!
Starting my run.
Try to engage this guy's shield. Alright, everyone out.
In progress.
The gravity well generator has been destroyed.
We gotta re-engage. Well, I guess this is what we got, so we'll see if this is enough.
Affirmative.
Because we have no
building started.
Garrison down there. For obvious reasons.
Tech upgrade under construction.
Whoa. Hopefully this is not the fleet. And it's just ground forces. Completely fucked this up. The pirates not only went after us, but we... let's retreat.
Preparing for jump to light speed.
Everyone out. That was irritating. Let's just get the Macron destroyers out. We can also start building these guys and these guys.
Constructing unit. Unit cancelled.
Let's get on it.
Constructing unit.
We can do is we can ship it again.
Order confirmed.
Honestly.
Transport ready.
Tactical battle imminent.
Too late.
This wasn't our battle to win.
And rip. Fuck's sake.
Lost. Tactical battle imminent.
Standing by. Proceeding to coordinates.
Yeek! It's this many shit!
Copy that. Advancing.
It's an actual fleet.
Calculating jump to light speed.
I thought it wasn't an actual fleet. I thought it was ground forces still. Fuck!
They're coming around.
That was stupid.
The Empire has advanced their tech level.
Let's build a couple of these as AA support for the fleets. Also, we're starting to get corrupted again.
Construction complete.
So, let's get ourselves
constructing
some of those. Yeah. Get the faster. To get that faster. Fucking hell. Faster vehicle builds. And I wanted to do something. Oh yeah, ships that can do point defense. No, not really. Tactical population 9, tactical population 9. Yeah, that actually makes quite a bit of sense, actually. If they're equal tactical population, except for laser cannons, this has heavy laser guns. I guess the best point of defense is just these for the New Republic.
Unit in production.
Yeah. Right, anyway. Up.
The Empire has advanced their techno.
Doesn't matter. Oh yeah, I wanted to decorrupt something. So I'm gonna need decorruption guys. There we go.
Level.
Alright. And there they go. Also, this thing doesn't want to finish for some reason. Well, that's very defendable. Let's go. Right. Now we've got some New Republic ships to work with.
Order confirmed.
The New Republic fleet is preparing to defend what?
On Calamari cruiser here.
Ion cannon available. Ion cannon firing.
Keep firing.
Our space station is under attack.
All right, we've got this guy. Ion cannon. We're going to break down his shields as soon as possible.
Heading for coordinates. Roger that. Consider it done. Form up.
You up. Full firepower.
Awaiting orders.
Turn that off. And just target hull. Blast them to smithereens. The hull, please.
Our space station is under attack.
Target the heavy guns. I copy.
Well, that's some fast gunboats. Incoming missiles. Right. Bombers, engage these one, folks.
Reporting.
You go after this guy. This guy's almost dead.
Yes, sir.
Come quickly, Google fire.
Yes, commander. Open fire.
Right, defensive shield.
Ready.
Ion cannon available.
Available.
Ion cannon
engage
firing.
Engage them again.
Why not get one on your tail? Attack formation. I'm
in.
Scratch
one. Cruiser.
Right. That sensor is done. Switch to the other one. All ships. Focus your firepower on the remaining Star Destroyer. Go! I literally nothing I can do about that.
You're coming around, Albert. You can't see him.
He
right.
Weapons charged.
Oh, we've got more Star Destroyers incoming.
Proceeding to location.
You're all over there. You need to start pulling around because... Yeah.
Ready.
Ow.
Awaiting orders.
Gauge ion cannons and defend your carrier. Laser cannons, blast these guys.
Copy. Right away. I copy. Reporting.
Mon Calamari cruiser here.
And you.
Mon Calamari
this
cruiser
way.
Ready. Ready for command.
We're almost there, come on! Just a couple more hits. Right, icon available. Target the AFU shielded. Whatchamacallit? Ship. You know what I mean. You know what?
Yes, sir. Yes, Commander. Moving out.
Right, that's dead. You retarget to the ton folks that are dithering about.
Our shield generator is down. Moving out. We lost the primary drive system.
Yep. Evacuate this one.
Awaiting orders.
If you could get a couple of missiles maybe on these guys. Thank you.
Ion
cannon available.
Ion cannon firing.
I've copied.
Watch your six. Loosen up.
Fall out.
Disable this guy.
Reporting.
Repositioning.
Scanners are offline.
Yes, Commander.
Our space station is under attack.
Ready.
Position to the side and engage.
Keep going.
You. In. You. Make a run on the other Star Destroyer's shield generator. Come on. Right now, lock on and fire.
Cruiser,
you target hull. You disable this guy.
Ion cannon available.
Ion cannon available. Disable the other detector.
Ready to commence attacking. Weapons charged.
Right. All available fighters, focus on the fire detector.
Weapons operational. Ready.
The one that's actually still firing at us. Or to be precise, at its weapons. Let me micro this.
Going for the lasers.
Or the way I'm microing this is I'm selecting the group, then telling them to attack, then deselecting some. So they are locked in on this target, on the first target, then selecting the secondary target, deselecting some. Now they're gonna go after the second target, and the rest are gonna go at the third target. Very simple.
Target those lasers. The laser banks are your primary target.
Mon Calamari cruiser ready. Open fire on those laser cannons. Ready for command. Targeting.
These guys engaging.
Ion Proton cannon available.
Just finish that shot. Blast this guy with an ion cannon. And that one's dead. Ion cannon is incoming. Oh, that's dead, unfortunately. Alright, Barracuda. That rush. Power of Barracuda.
Ion cannon available. Beginning construction.
Slap some cannons here.
Building under construction. Building started.
Just for future generations. And let's.
This way.
The hunt begins.
Construction complete. Construction complete. Construction complete.
We've got them on the run.
They're just running. Perfect.
Construction complete.
All right. That actually built. We also need more freighters because they keep getting blasted. But for that, we're gonna need to wait for the paycheck.
Get ready to deploy.
And the paycheck has come. Also, where the fuck is it? Over with the way.
Cleared for departure.
Unit and production imminent.
Chadwin. Because why not? We do have a tier 2 base, so we can try.
En route. Construction complete.
That's
complete.
Fuck.
Construction complete.
Blast this fucking shield generator! What's so hard?
Gravity well generator has been destroyed.
Amazing. Come on!
Look out!
Crap. Someone have a missile?
Standing by. Star Cruiser here. Star Cruiser standing by.
Reporting.
Frigate reporting. Attack! Maximum fire!
I need help here!
Space station damaged.
I need help!
Yep, you should be able to blast this thing. Smithereens.
We're on the move.
Retreat in progress.
And we're out.
They're drawing their fire.
No good. I can't maneuver.
In Alarmbereitschaft.
All right. We're taking this fleet for a spin again. The Exedra fleet.
As you wish.
Ready to move.
Liberator cruiser reporting. Jumping to light speed.
Construction here to complete.
Alright.
Yes, sir.
Of course,
jamming
this.
Sensors.
Actually, you're gonna stop and wait for. Actually, just disengage the ship.
Liberation reporting. Yes, Commander. Order confirmed.
Straight through, straight through.
This is a liberation here for the Alliance.
You blast this guy.
Squadron reporting. Standing by. Ready for orders. This way. Over there.
Star Destroyer reporting in.
Right, Exedra. Show them what you're made of. Target the captor.
Holding fire.
Strike fast. You too.
We've got them on scope.
Target the nearest captor.
Maximum firepower.
Ready.
Force will guide us.
Roger. Roger that. Advancing.
All right, men. Take cover.
Ready for commands.
Cruiser, standing by.
You're going straight through. Come on.
Standing by.
Curve. Keep your guns in this guy. I guess. Whatever. Blast this. You. This again. You're just trying to fall back.
Awaiting orders.
We need to clean this up, people. And we need to do it fast.
Target the engines. They're not going anywhere.
Ready to commence. Direct fire on the engines. The engines are our primary target.
Awaiting your orders.
All right.
Constructing.
We've retaken that. Defended everything. Yep. So. And that is gonna have to be, please, more 26. All right, that is gonna be have to it for today. So thanks everyone for watching. Like if liked it, subscribe if you want to, and of course see you next time. Take care.